हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ श्रीमती आर एस कालिया प्राइमरी स्कूल। माय सेल्फ मिस जीनत हनानी। टुडे वी विल बी स्टडी इंग्लिश ग्रामर टॉपिक नाउंस जेंडर। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डन नाउंस नंबर, टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग ऑन नाउंस जेंडर। ओके, नाउ लेट अस सी द फर्स्ट काइंड ऑफ जेंडर, मैस्कुलाइन gender. Such nouns denote a male person or animal. Masculine genders refer to male person or animal. Example, man, boy, uncle. So masculine genders always refer to male people or male animal. You can say lion. Okay, we can also add lion here. Lion, tiger, masculine gender. Next we have the feminine gender. Such nouns denote a female person or animal. Feminine genders always refer to females. Okay, either female person or female animal. Example, woman, sister, aunt. For lion, you can say lioness. So remember that feminine genders always refer to females. Then we come to common gender. From the word common itself, you can understand common gender. Such nouns denote either a male or a female. That means it is a word or a noun which is common for male and female. Example, child. Parent, teacher, friend, all these nouns are commonly used. A child means either a male child or a female child. If you specify the name of the child, then it will come in the category of masculine or feminine gender. But if you say only child, it can be used as a common gender. Let us see parent. Parent can be either mother or father. Teacher, friend, all these nouns are used as common gender. It can be used for either a male or a female. And the last kind of gender is neuter gender. What do you mean by neuter gender? Such nouns denote lifeless things, things without life, neither male nor female. That means lifeless things. Example, house, chair, table, ball, things without life come in the category of neuter gender. So in all we have four kinds of gender: masculine, feminine, common and neuter. Now we will see that there are three ways in which a feminine noun can be formed from a masculine noun. Okay? There are three ways. Let us look at all the ways one by one. The ways in which a feminine noun can be formed from a masculine noun. The first way, by adding ess to the masculine. What you have to do, the masculine noun is given. To make it to the feminine noun or to change it to the feminine noun, you have to add ess. Okay? For example, host, H-O-S-T, host, becomes hostess. Host is the masculine noun, and when you change it to the feminine noun, it becomes hostess. Simply you have to add ess. Poet, masculine poet, when you change it to feminine, it becomes poetess. ess is added. Prince. Prince becomes princess. But since over here, E is there, we have only becomes like this. Simply adding ESS. Shepherd. Shepherd becomes shepherdess. Priest becomes priestess. Okay. Now, there are some words where the form is slightly changed. A simple change of the form or a slight change of the form. That means sometimes the form is slightly changed before ESS is added. See, I'll give you an example. Let us take the masculine noun God. You know that when you have to make it to the feminine noun, you will add ESS. But when you change God to Goddess, we will write it as GODDESS. You have to add the D here. Okay? One more example. Actor. The masculine noun actor, the spelling feminine noun is actress. But you will not write A-C-T-O-R-E-S. No. The spelling of actress is A-C-T-R-E-S. The O will not be there. Are you understanding? Other examples are hunter. H-U-N-T-E-R. Hunter changes to huntress. The E is omitted. Tiger, tigress. E is omitted. T-I-G-R-E-S-S. Okay? Emperor. O is omitted. Empress. So there are some words, not many, in which there is a slight change before E-S-S is added. And mostly you will see that the vowels are changed. The vowel is removed. Okay? Either E is there or O is there. But in case of God, you have to add one more D. G-O-D-D-E-S-S. Okay. Some feminines are formed. Hero. Heroine. Widow. Widower. Widow. Bridegroom. Bride. So there are some words which are changed accordingly. Mr. M-R. Mr. Mrs. Okay. So now we will see how these words are changed. Second rule is by a change of word. That is what I told you. The entire word changes. You don't have to add anything. The word itself changes. I gave you the example. Hero becomes heroine. Mr. becomes Mrs. Bridegroom, bride, boy, girl, horse, man. Okay? The masculine is horse and the feminine is man. Sir, madam. So, in these to make feminine, the entire masculine word will change. Other examples are bull, cow, father, mother, gentleman, lady, brother, sister, son, daughter, uncle, aunt, and so on. Many words are there, which you will see in your next book, that the word itself, the masculine word or the masculine noun itself changes to a new word. And the third rule is feminines of compound nouns. I already explained you compound made of two words. Okay, a noun which is made of two words. Example, peacock. Peacock is a compound noun. Why? Because it is made up of pea and cock. You don't write it separately. You write it together, peacock. But it is a compound noun because it is made up of pea and cock. Okay? So, peacock becomes peahen. Landlord becomes landlady. This is also a compound noun. Landlord. Two words. Landlady. Gentleman. Compound nouns are made up of more than one word. Gentleman becomes lady. Okay, other examples I'll give you. washerwoman, and so on. So these are compound nouns, the masculine compound nouns, and how they are changed to the feminine compound nouns. When the noun changes from masculine to feminine, the pronoun and the possessive adjective in the sentence must also change. What do we mean by this? That when you change the noun from masculine to feminine, you also have to change the pronoun and the possessive adjective. Let us understand this with the help of example. The king went to the palace. He ate his lunch. Now, king is a masculine noun, so the king will change to queen. So the queen went to the palace. He becomes she. The pronoun he becomes the pronoun she. Ate his lunch. His becomes her. Are you understanding how to change? See, let's look at the next example. His brother is an actor. He always plays the part of a hero in a film. His changes to her. Brother changes to sister. Actor changes to actress. He becomes she. Always plays the part of a hero. Hero masculine noun changes to heroine in a film. So these are the ways in which you will change, but you also have to change the pronoun. Only changing the masculine to feminine will not help. Simultaneously, you also have to change the pronoun and the possessive adjective. I'll give you more examples. The father loved the eldest son very much. He left him all his property. So the father changes to mother. The mother loved the eldest. Father loved the eldest son. So son changes to daughter. He becomes she. She, he left him. Him becomes her. All his property. His changes to her. So the mother loved the eldest daughter very much. She left her all her property. Okay? One more example. His uncle has a car. He goes to office in his car. His uncle changes to her aunt. His changes to her and uncle changes to aunt. Has a car. He goes to office. He becomes she. He goes to office in his car. His changes to her. So her aunt has a car. She goes to office in her car. So remember, when you change masculine to feminine, you also need to change the pronoun as well as the possessive adjective. Okay, let us look at the exercise. Rewrite the sentences changing the masculine nouns to the feminine. What you have to do here, you have to rewrite the sentence again by changing the masculine nouns to the feminine. First of all, you have to identify which is the masculine noun. That man is the father of six sons. Okay? So first we will analyze the masculine nouns. Man, father, and sons. Okay? So now, that means that man changes to woman. Okay? Man changes to woman. Is the father changes to mother. Masculine of feminine of father is mother. Mother of six sons changes to daughters. Remember, you have to add the S, okay, because it is sons. So that man is the father of changes to bride. Feminine of bridegroom is bride. The bride was a young means young. Man changes to woman. Okay. And last we have very.
Changes from
the pronoun and the possessive adjective must also change. Only changing the masculine noun to the feminine noun will not be enough. You also have to change the pronoun and the possessive adjective. He becomes she, his becomes her. Okay? So, here we end the chapter. I hope.